greetings world. We are anonymous. As radiation levels spike, and mutated wildlife rushes ashore, government and media promote delusion. Radiation hotspots are popping up around the United States, thousands of percentages higher than background radiation. Mutated wildlife is being found dead on the same West Coast beaches where increased radiation levels have been documented by independent researchers, and the Fukushima TEPCO plant workers have been caught using duct tape to fix their nuclear equipment. But according to both the Japanese and United States governments, these events mean absolutely nothing. In fact, you must be a conspiracy theorist if you fail to believe the official story that it was likely red-painted utensils that led to a spike in documented radiation levels along the California coast. Yes, the government actually offered this up as an official answer. And you must absolutely be a conspiracy theorist if you have the gall to actually look back to late 2011, when researchers presented their findings regarding the impending wave of Fukushima radiation that was already being recorded within the country. Information going back to 2011 shows that scientists were already concerned about an increase in radiation levels and the overall fallout from the dilapidated Fukushima plant. We can even go back to the declaration by scientist Marco Caldofen of the Worcester Polytechnic Institute that radioactive hot particles had been found at 2 out of the 3 radiation monitoring stations in Boston. As you are likely aware, hot particles are microscopic pieces of radioactive material that can absolutely wreak havoc on your body via the deliverance of concentrated radiation. And these particles, according to Caldofen, were already been found in Boston as far back as 2011. Now enter new flowing up stories that have seemingly been popping up one after another as radiation levels are continually being monitored around the nation, namely the West Coast, where the bulk of Fukushima-linked scenarios have been documented. In what sounds like an apocalyptic plot for the latest thriller film, we have mutated whales now washing up dead on the West Coast in the first ever documented case of conjoined gray whale calves. We even have elevated radiation readings as far away as St. Louis, Missouri. Coincidentally, of course, this is happening at the same time that radiation hotspots, exceeding a 1,400% increase over normal levels, are being reported by researchers. It's even happening at the same time that similar 500% increases have been disregarded by government officials who admit they have no idea what's going on but fervently deny any connection to Fukushima in any capacity whatsoever. In fact, that has always been the mantra of these government health officials: we have no idea what's really going on, but it's definitely not Fukushima. Because just as the Japanese government has assured its citizens that Fukushima is perfectly safe and poses no real threat to human health, while secretly reviewing studies that reveal the plant released massively more radiation than admitted and led to 78% of the radioactive waste being dumped into the Pacific Ocean, the United States government would much rather silently purchase 14 million doses of potassium iodide than tell you that there may be some cause for concern. While the spread of radiation to the west coast of North America was casually acknowledged, the early press reports, quoting diplomatic sources, stated that only tiny amounts of radioactive particles have arrived in California but do not pose a threat to human health. According to the news agencies, the unnamed sources have access to data from a network of measuring stations run by the United Nations Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty Organization. Greg Jachko, chair of the U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission, told White House reporters that his experts don't see any concern from radiation levels that could be harmful here in the United States or any of the U.S. territories. A map of citizens' measured radiation levels shows radioactivity is distributed in a complex pattern reflecting the mountainous terrain and the shifting winds across a broad area of Japan, north of Tokyo, which is in the center of the bottom of the map. While most of the automotive industry is in central Japan, Nissan's engine factory in Iwaki City is 42 kilometers from the Fukushima Daiichi plant. Is the Nissan workforce affected? Is the engine plant contaminated? The plant is within about 10 to 20 kilometers of the government's evacuation zone, from which some 200,000 people were evacuated. the very core of the Fukushima disaster timeline that has been regurgitated by the mainstream media and government agencies alike was almost exclusively based on information provided by plant operator TEPCO, a company that is now on record as having lied to the population of the world in a major way. And there were no signs they would ever tell the truth unless forced to. It wasn't until an independent investigation revealed the actual levels of radiation released from the plant, around 2.5 times more than TEPCO would even admit, that TEPCO was forced to go on record and state that the radiation levels they released were indeed much lower than reality. However, the independent investigation into Fukushima radiation levels not only exposed the lies by TEPCO regarding the radiation explosion at the plant, but it also found that around 78% of the cesium-137 released by the plant was funneling into the Pacific Ocean. The plant now states that the three reactor meltdowns at the Fukushima Daiichi plant released about 900,000 terabecquerels of radioactive substances. About 20% fell on Japanese land, 2% somewhere on land outside the country, and a whopping 78% remainder is believed to have entered the Pacific Ocean. At the very least, the Japanese and United States governments should be preparing citizens for what scientists say could last thousands of years, this Fukushima nightmare. And that begins with admitting that the threat is real. Because, unless we really prepare ourselves and work together as a planet to truly fix the Fukushima plant and ensure that the 1,400 plus rods do not cause yet another massive meltdown, as experts say they likely will during transfer, if so, we really will be facing a radioactive nightmare of epic proportions. We are Anonymous. We are Legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.
Everything that I suspected then has been proven, because people were so fed up, scientists who are honest were so fed up with all this fraudulent quiet climate change scam, and they hacked into the headquarters in England and into the Lawrence Livermore lab, and they got thousands of emails between the British climate change scientists and the U.S. climate change group at Livermore, and they proved that the whole climate change concept is completely fraud. And it's actually been perpetrated and made up and promoted from the City of London and the Queen of England to promote nuclear power so that she can sell her uranium. Queen Elizabeth owns all of the uranium in Canada, in much of Africa, and in Australia. And there's no way for her to peddle that useless energy unless she can sell it for weapons or for nuclear power. So that in itself, to think and realize that Queen Elizabeth's uranium has poisoned the world, all of the depleted uranium weapons, Iraq, Afghanistan, everywhere we've used them, Yugoslavia, that's all Canadian uranium, and it's completely illegal because it violates the Canadian Constitution.
Right. Now, what you said is, quote, anyone with a desire to stay healthy should never go to Hawaii or any Pacific islands in our lifetime. and then you go on, as you explained, one of the main Pacific Ocean currents is carrying the radiation from Fukushima directly east across the Pacific Ocean. Does that mean that you believe that Hawaii should be evacuated at this time?
We said that right after Fukushima happened. All of the Pacific Islands north of the equator should be evacuated. They should have been evacuated as soon as Fukushima happened. And even the northern one-third of Japan should have been evacuated, including Tokyo. Of course, that would be very difficult and incredibly expensive to do, and they're not going to do it because the people who have perpetrated this global outrage, they are using radiation, nuclear weapons, radiation, nuclear power, which produces fission products, and they're creating a global nuclear pollution situation, which is going to have many biological and ecological effects that are not favorable to life on this planet. And they are combining nuclear weapons and nuclear pollution for depopulation with HARP technologies and applications, such as the Fukushima tectonic nuclear warfare disaster, where they triggered the Tohoku earthquake at Fukushima with HARP and caused it to release huge amounts of fission products, which is a silent global nuclear war. And there's no place to hide. The tuna at the Tsukiji fish market in Tokyo, which I've been to many times, it's over a square mile, it's huge. And there are all these people running around with chainsaws, sawing up frozen whales and frozen tuna and just huge fish and everything, and even sea mammals. The price of tuna this year at their sale, which started a few weeks ago, was 95% down from what they were paying for tuna last year. In other words, the price was 5% this year of what they paid 100% for last year. So the tuna industry, the fish industry is just falling through the floor in Japan, and China and Russia have said they are curtailing imports of food from the west coast of North America, and they may not buy any more fish. We know that the Pacific Ocean, the seaweed, the fish, the plankton, everything is contaminated now from Fukushima. This is from the Arctic all the way to the Antarctic. And this great conveyor belt that controls the world climate, it's actually the heat sink for the world's climate, circulates through the Pacific and then back through Southeast Asia into the Atlantic, around the Atlantic, back through Southeast Asia, around the Pacific. So this is just a giant mixing machine in the oceans. And then the air also behaves as a fluid, and that has an even more turbulent, more violent, more convective mixing effect that's much faster than in the ocean. We do know from NOAA samples, the National Oceanographic and Atmospheric Administration in the federal government, that they took samples, I think in April or May after Fukushima happened, just a month or two. And this was up in Alaska, and the Alaska fish and seaweed already demonstrated that bioaccumulation had happened. And what that means in the fish and the seaweed is that the seaweed and